Good morning, everyone. Why don't you prepare yourself to worship? If you want to stand, stand. If you want to sit or lay down or however that looks for you, why don't you get in the posture to worship? I want to remind us that in the book of Acts, we read that the disciples were gathered together on the day of Pentecost. And this morning, us being together, our togetherness looks a little different. We're not all together in one room, but what does bring us together is that we come into this place right now to worship Jesus. We're together not because we're in close proximity to each other. We're together because we're collectively turning our attention and our affection to Jesus right now, to worship him because he is worthy of our worship. So Jesus, we have this expectation to meet with you right now. We give you our praise. We give you our attention. We give you our affection. Everything else that's happening in life, we put to the side right now, because you are the focus, you are the key, you are what this is all about. We thank you for what happened thousands of years ago when you poured out your spirit on those believers in that room, and we pray that you would pour out your spirit on us again this morning, that we would receive a fresh infilling of your spirit and your presence in every home and every stream watching this and in this room and in this building today. Jesus, this is all for you. We give you our best praise, our best worship. We love you, Lord. Amen.
Put your hands together with us wherever you are. And let's just love on Jesus here.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb. Till I met you,
come on, sing. I was breathing,
but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my
So Father, we love you, and we lift our voices and our hearts. We turn all our attention to you fully. And God, no matter what we're facing, what kind of fear, God, we thank you that the fear is being broken down, anxiety is being broken down, the darkness is being pierced, and things are, doors are opening up, new seasons are cracking open. And so we thank you, God, that no matter the season we're in, we always have something to praise about, something to sing about, because you're faithful and you're good. So this morning, we lift our hearts and our voices to you, and we lift this up. Sing this with me.
I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies,
yeah.
Oh, I raise a hallelujah, oh, louder than the unbelief.
Come on, lift it up.
Oh, I raise a
Thank you. And our Father, all of heaven roars your name, sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. Our Father, all of heaven roars your name, sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth.
Yeah.
The sound of heaven touching earth. Spirit break out. Yeah. Break all walls down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. Invite your Holy Spirit. Break our walls down. Break down every limitation that we have on you based on our thinking and our imagination. You are so far above and beyond what we could ever ask or imagine. And so we invite you right now. to break down those walls. Break down the walls of what we think is possible. There is no limitation in you. There is no limitation in you. And so we submit to you, Holy Spirit. Today, celebrating Pentecost Sunday, we have a prayer that we want to pray together, something we want to declare. Because for a lot of people in the room, we're not allowed to sing, but we can talk and we can pray. We can speak out loud. So let these words be your worship. Let these words be your prayer. And let's just say this out. Thank you, Father, for the lavish gift of your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me and cleansing me with your blood to make me a temple for your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, Son, and Spirit, that I am filled with you by the Holy Spirit. Let's say this all together. Come on, lift our voices. I give you permission to reveal yourself in me fully and to flow through me freely. Let's say that again. I give you permission to reveal yourself in me fully and to flow through me freely. I invite you to baptize me in your great power so that torrents of living water would flood the world around me. I repent for devaluing your place in my life and heart, and I choose today to let you lead me and empower me to be a witness for Jesus. Amen. Amen. Yeah, amen, amen. So sing this with me.
Set a fire down in my soul I can't contain. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, I can't control.
We won't contain you, we won't control you.
Come on. Set a fire down my soul.
Come on, if you can sing it, sing it. You can say it, say it.
A fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God.
Come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a
fire down in my soul.
my soul that I can't contain, I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, I can't control. I wanna know you fully. I wanna know you fully. Awaken me to your fullness. Awaken me to the truth of who you are.
In your homes, even if you're here in the room, begin to just lift up your thanksgiving and praise to the Lord. Just begin to thank Him. Just speak out your thanksgiving. Speak out your thanksgiving. We thank you, God. You're faithful. Beyond what we could ask or imagine. Thank you, God. You're beautiful. We want more. Now begin to confess your desire for more. Just speak out. Father, I want more of you. Even in the room, you can do that. Go ahead. Begin to speak out. Just speak out. I want more of you, God. I want more of you. You're worthy. You're worthy. You're worthy. You're worthy. You're worthy. You're worthy. Father, come and come and move amongst us here. Come and move amongst us in our homes. Hallelujah. There's been a couple of words of knowledge that have been on my heart this morning that I want to lean into in this moment. I feel like God is bringing healing to digestive issues. He didn't give me any particular ones, but healing to digestive issues. Although I'm hearing right now gallstones. So I'm going to be praying over that in just a moment. I also heard the Lord speaking about dealing with mental anguish, depression, different mental illnesses, just where the organ of the brain is needing physical healing. So we're going to join in and pray about that in just a moment. And finally, I'm hearing the Lord speak about supernatural provision. Prayer, there's many who are praying for provision. We're going to join our faith together about that. So Father, in Jesus' name, I speak over these digestive ailments, especially the issue of gallstones. Father, in Jesus' name, I command stones to dissolve. I command all pain to go. I command normal digestive order to come to your bodies in Jesus' name. And I speak life and peace over your body right now. I'm also, Father, I speak over the issues of the mind, Lord, where the brain, where it just needs chemicals brought into kingdom order right now. I speak over clinical depression, physical depression, anxiety, schizophrenia. I felt earlier to pray over autism, over these different things. In Jesus' name, we command the brain to come into kingdom order right now, to function appropriately, for chemical levels to be in perfect kingdom order right now. And I speak life over your bodies. I command depression to go, the physical depression, and now I speak to spiritual depression. You wicked spirit, leave right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I speak over areas of provision. I speak supernatural provision. Lord, we agree together for people who have physical, financial needs, Father, right now, for supernatural provision. We join our faith with them, Lord. You said if any two ask anything in your name, it would be done. So, Father, we ask it in your name. Come and bring provision supernaturally to our friends and family in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I just want to rest here for just a moment. Allow Holy Spirit to speak to us. Come, Holy Spirit. You're so good. You're so faithful. We love and honor you. We bless you. Hallelujah. Katie's got a song on her heart. Go ahead, Katie.
There's no place I'd rather be. There's no place I'd rather be. There's no place I'd rather be than here in your love, here in your love. No place I'd rather be. There's no place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be than here in your love, here in your love. No place I'd rather be. There's no place I'd rather be. There's no place I'd rather be than here in your love, here in your love. There's no place.
rather be than in your love.
The shadow of fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control.
Spirit and set a new fire in our hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and awaken us to you. Awaken our soul. Those of you at home and those of you here, just begin to reach out and just invite, awaken my soul to you, Holy Spirit. I want more. I want more. Father, you're faithful. We love and we honor you. We bless you in this time. Come and minister life and peace in your precious name. Amen. Amen.